And it never works. Politician and prophet are always at diametrically opposed. I wish it wasn't that way. But for the most part, glory to God. Let's get one more question going here.
Thank you, Brother Clark. The man over here that was so bluntly honest with us, and my question would probably go into that area. You've taught us about perimeters and not stepping outside of that. I have a friend that will be here tonight, Lord willing, with a dire need, life and death need. And my question is, with some that may not be in the higher power levels, what will happen, as the brother asked, as to messing up and not being able to handle simply because they're not ready at that power level?
This man that's coming is sick. This woman is afflicted. All right. Well, she'll either get healed or she won't. There's the first fact. And if the lower power level operators, as you put it, do not have success, we'll just keep throwing another arrow out of the quiver and shoot it until one of them strikes. Amen. Somebody will touch God. Somebody will have the proper key. See, the key for success is how to pray. The right prayer unlocks the door. I can come up against a locked door and put a whole ring of keys in there. None of them may fit, but there is one key somewhere that fits that door. And it'll open the door. And that's the power of prayer. If you pray the right prayer, that's the key to unlock the door of faith. Glory. So let's be looking for the right key. That is the right prayer. Pray correctly. Prayer is a powerful thing. Biggest doctrine in the Bible. And depends on how you apply prayer. That's how the prayer of faith is answered. Now, I can pray for all the missionaries, all the evangelists, all the pastors, all the church. Oh, God, give revival. I can't tell. Nothing happens. It's too wide. It's the scope of the universe here. But if I pray specifically, let Sister Jones receive sight in her left eye, then the prayer can be answered, and I'll know it's answered because I prayed specifically. See, I prayed the right prayer. I didn't pray for her to get the Holy Ghost baptism. I prayed for what I wanted. The left eye opened. See? Okay, can we now? Oh, well, come on, sister. We want you to get your nap. We want you to get your meal. We want you to stretch your legs this afternoon. So, we thank God for questions, but we've been on it for a while.
I was kind of nervous in coming up here, so I'm glad you called me. I've been struggling with a difficult situation in my home church, and I had read in the Bible about Saul and the same things he went over today on a trip last week. And I come here and we study it again. And I feel like God had spoke to me, and he said, "You've killed your bear. You've killed your lion, and this was my giant." And
the giant being specifically what?
The situation that I'm going through now with my church, just like you said, if there's no revelation gifts being used in the church, there's something being hidden. And I won't get into specifics, but when I was praying in intercessory prayer, that God spoke to me, and it was just as though that demonic spirit that oppresses that church and the person that it's dealing with, that is coming against me. It was like God spoke out through me. You tell them you're going to get prophets to pray about this situation. And I said, well, you know, we have 400 prophets of Baal, but we have enough prophets here that if you would intercede, I came here for a purpose, and it's for that church. And it's God's people. And I got irritated at one time, and I said, God, I just can't stand it. God said, that's my church you're talking about. And I've just been very burdened over it. And I just, sometimes I felt so weak, I felt like I was right in the middle of the fire. And I didn't think I was going to make it through, because it's just a different level for me that God has put me in. I said, why me, Lord? But there's nobody else that can stand there. So I just need to strengthen the Lord. every situation that I've been placed in around there, the enemy has opposed, but then there also have been little glimpses of breakthrough. So I just wanted to put that before you, if you would pray about our church.
We certainly will pray. No person is beyond touching, though God does protect his ministry. If you are of a truth, a sincere intercessor and a pillar and an anchor and a foundation to hold the church together, you will pray, we will pray. And the burden that's leaving you weak might just be the price that's being paid to keep the lid from blowing off something in that church. Because God knows we got a whole nation full of churches that just everything in the world goes on. And ministries topple and reputations go down the tubes and things happen. And they would happen more often if there wasn't some restraining force there and some resistance to it or some answerable something there. Answering to something, some way to check and balance. So it may be God is making you weak so that you can keep something from happening. I mean, we don't want any church to be destroyed or split or any reputation to be soiled or any ministry to go down the tubes, do we? So if you have reason to believe that you ought to be doing something, that something is intercession, is prayer.
Our ministry has been suffocated too because it's like Saul spirit is there.
Well, there's reasons for that. And could be jealousy, could be competition, could be fear, could be covering something, could be that God's putting a little thorn in your nest and getting you ready to go do your own ministry too. So you don't know. And either people are going to go for the supernatural or they're not. And that's a basic fact. They're going to have a hunger for it and a desire, or they're just going to give up and exhaust and say, it's too big, it's too much of a challenge, I can't be bothered, let's do it my way. That's a fact too. Well, praise God for these questions, and the Spirit's help us to answer them as we have. And take it and run with it and try it and stand upon it and believe it and act on it and see if it works before you just chuck it out the window. After all, we spend a lot of energy bringing it up, you know. You're inquiring of the Lord and we're trying to get answers here. But I know there's lots of questions, but it's getting late. I want Brother Edwards and myself to do this because I have no intention from the start in these seminars of trying to be a one-man show and do everything myself. I wind up having to do the bulk of it. I know that. I know. I dread these things every summer. I know what kind of work it does. Yesterday I was in the pulpit 9 hours. Anyway, it has to be done, and we only have a little time in this day and age to get it done. 3 days. I mean, you're so scheduled you couldn't get here no other time, and if you weren't in the habit and the routine of coming, some of you, you wouldn't have been here now. You've got in the swing of it, you see, used to it. Brother Edwards and myself are going to lay hands upon all of you for the impartation and the confirmation of the particular gift that you're pursuing. Now, when you come down here, don't ask for all 9 gifts. Give yourself a break. Try to get a hold of one and use that first. And if you can use that, God will give you more. If you absolutely must ask for 2, choose wisely. But the more you ask for, the harder it's going to be. I warn you, it'd be better to have a bird in the hand than 2 in the bush. Say amen. Happy? All right. It's a few minutes past 2. Do you mind? Okay. This is a lifetime lent to the Lord here. I'm quoting Samuel. If you're not a mind to operate this gift, don't ask for it. If you don't want to be God's property and have him for your boss, don't ask for it. If you want to run your own show and do your own thing, do what you please, don't be asking for a gift because you will shorten your life. God takes people. He never takes gifts. Are you ready? I'll tell you what we're going to do. We will split the congregation down the middle here. Right through here. This half on this side, this half on this side. I'm going to give Brother Edwards this half to lay hands upon. Here's what we're going to do. And I know, I'm sure Brother Edwards knows what to do. We're going to ask you what gift you're going to tell us. And we're going to lay hands upon you to ordain, confirm, and send you forth to begin operating, even though it's in a baby stage. We're going to ask God to seed it, make the embryo, or birth it. And you're going to have to birth it fast, because tonight it's got to operate. Say hallelujah. Okay? Everybody rise. I'll take this half, Brother Edwards, if you take that half. And come to the front and stand all across. And remember where you're standing so we can divide right here. And this will enable us to go twice as fast, because the gift of God is with Brother Edwards like it is with myself. So all we need to do is to endorse this. Hallelujah. Glory to God. In fact, I won't even need the microphone.
Jesus, my heart is given to you. The journey of spirits. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me up. Jesus, I'll never forget Hallelujah. Rain, Jesus. Welcome. Welcome to the 1996 14th consecutive Gifts of the Spirit seminar. Great things will be happening from this opening night forward. We're going to have three great nights in a row and two great mornings in a row. And, well, it's back. It's happening. Many of you come a long ways. We know this place is going to be packed and jammed before too many more minutes tonight. They'll be coming in as the time progresses, although we officially start at 7 o'clock. Everybody say 7 o'clock. 7 o'clock. And tomorrow morning, the session begins promptly at 10 o'clock. Say 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock.
It will last until. But you will get your afternoon nap and your mid-afternoon lunch. And then again at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. On the final night of this seminar, we will be having every seminarist operating. So you better get all you can all you get. You better get as much as soon as possible. We know we can't rush it, but every time we spend our lives and time around this, the supernatural revelation, we will grow, we will expand, and you've come a long way. Some folks has come from many states. Some are sleeping on the ground underneath tents, since the dorm rooms are all filled all up and down the road here. And for that, I believe God will reward them. For they cannot possibly make a sacrifice except God honors a sacrifice. Amen. And also you that reserved your rooms with your deposit, if you need it back, just let us know. We promised we'd give it to you. Or you might even be under conviction before this thing's over with and want to contribute. Who knows? Hallelujah to God. Wonderful Jesus. Thank God. Amen. So much is going to happen here tonight and the next 3 days. Why? You're bound to enjoy some of it. And you're bound to receive something from some of it. And it's that time again. So it's a holy convocation. That means a convening, a convention of sorts, and we have a spring convention here and a fall convention, and this is the summer convention, and they study here all winter, so four seasons. And this is a holy convening or convocation, and I think we ought to just stop now and dedicate it to the Lord and let him have his way by worshiping him. Let's do that very thing. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, oh, praising his name. Glory be to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, now. Invite him. Invoke his presence. Cease not to cry. Oh, reach out. Dedicate. Consecrate. Resign yourself to him. Yield. Oh, glory. Stretch your withered arm. Oh, God, awake us and make us aware. Consecrate us now. Sanctify us. Prepare our hearts. We do not come in the flesh. We come in the Spirit. We do not come leaning on our own understanding. The carnal mind is enmity against God. It is not subject to the law of God. Neither indeed can be. To be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. They that are in the flesh cannot please God. Put us in the Spirit, Lord. We need to please Thee now. And without faith it is impossible to please Thee, so we believe You even greater. Savior, raise my faith in Thee till it can move a mountain. Lord, I believe. Oh, Lord, I believe. All my doubts are buried in the fountain. We're here to be led by Your Spirit, O God. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God. We have learned long ago the secret of obeying God. In two words, who can tell me what's the secret of obeying God? Quit thinking. Turn your brains off. Stay open. Let a higher mind enter you. Let this mind be in you that was also in Christ Jesus, who thought it not robbery to be called equal with God, but took on the form of a servant, humbled himself to the death of the cross, and ascended up on high, triumphant. We're here to glorify his name, the name by which the whole family in heaven and earth is named. All glory. The name at which every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that he is Lord, to the glory of God. That name that God hath highly exalted, that name that I don't speak too often, so that when I do speak it, it will accomplish great things. It's a sacred name. Hallelujah. We can pray in the name of Tom, Dick, and Harry. We can expect nothing. We can pray a little more religiously in the name of Peter, James, and John, and nothing will happen still. We can invoke the name of the Prince of Peace, the Lily of the Valley, the name of the Bright and Morning Star, the name of the Wheel in the Middle of the Wheel, and all these accolades and all these references and all these referrals. However, until we pray in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, we won't see any devils crying of loud voices and coming out. And we'll not see the sick healed in the name of Buddha, Mohammed, Confucius, Mary Baker Eddy, Joseph Smith, nor Brigham Young, or Hare Krishna, or all the rest. Ah, glory. Thank God. Praising God. And of all the names in heaven and earth, there is none more exalted. And today and tonight, we may not have a monopoly on it, but we stand by faith. And we are thrilled that we are privileged to use his name to meet all of our needs, both physically, spiritually, mentally, financially, emotionally, physically, in every which way. I love him, don't you? Glory to God. I want you to go now and shake about 3 or 4 hands and go visit somebody. And before you come back to your seat, make sure you tell them who you are and make them welcome and tell them you're glad to have them. And in fact, tell them you're glad to be here. In fact, some of you just tell them you are here. Go ahead, meet a few folks. Just go on and meet a half a dozen folks. We're going to meet them later anyway, but you get a head start now. Oh, my God.
Praise God. And he sent a message to the highways and the byways and said, compel them to come in. At first, he just invited those who normal people would have thought should have wanted to come anyhow to the feast, but they wouldn't come. One had married a wife and family cares had choked him, and one had bought a parcel of ground and earthly cares had choked him. And one had bought 5 yoke of oxen and business cares choked him out. And somebody asked Jesus, why wouldn't they come? And Jesus said, because they were not worthy. Now, no matter who you think looks worthy, it is not in being called, it's being chosen. It's not just in being invited, but it's in answering the call. And when you get there, putting on the wedding garment, comply. I mean, put ye on the Lord Jesus Christ and make no provision for the flesh. Let the Lord do to you and apply to you and put on you what he wants to. After all, it's his wedding and it's his feast. Thank God. And many have been invited, and an awful lot have come, and we're going to be meeting all those who have come, and I know they've made a great sacrifice. And those who are here tonight are representative of the ministry. That does not mean they are all pastors of churches. I mean, maybe for some of you, the last thing you ever want to do is pastor a pulpit. But you have ministries, or you would not be here. Even in this first session, tonight we're going to deal with those ministries. And a little bit later, speak on the subject of the birth of a prophet. And the theme for this year, I have felt, is the prophet Samuel. Last year, I believe it was Elijah. The year before, Elisha. But Samuel is a great prophet. If it'll work in the Old Testament, it'll work in the New Testament. That's for sure. If it'll work on an Old Testament prophet, certainly you can be able ministers of the New Testament. Thank God. God have said in the church first. 1 Corinthians 12 and Ephesians 4:11. First, apostles. Secondarily, and thirdly, it said teachers, but in Corinthians it breaks it down. In Ephesians it breaks it down into evangelists, pastors, and teachers. So you have a fivefold ministry. So get ready. You're not going to leave here like you came, in Jesus' name. Praise God. We're just moving along slow right now, trying to get you tuned up in the spirit, and get you focused, get you channeled, and get you harnessed, get you used to a new hen yard, a new environment, and get beside yourself and beyond yourself and forget yourself. Right now, I want you to picture we're underneath the big tent, and the choir's here, and the organist is here, and you're here, and Jesus is here. The Holy Ghost is here. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord till I die. Oh, I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord till I die. You know what that means? That means I'll believe God if it kills me. I will lean on the Lord. I will lean on the Lord. I will
till I die. Oh, believe him tonight. I will trust in the Lord. I will lean on his word. I will trust in the Lord till I die. Why don't you have faith in God? Have a little more faith in God. Have faith in God for deliverance. Have faith. Have faith. Faith in God. Oh, oh, faith in God can move a mighty mountain. Oh, faith in God can calm the troubled sea. Oh, faith can make this desert look like a fountain. Oh, faith can bring the victory. So ask and ye shall receive. Yes, you will. Oh, seek and you shall find. You believe it? Go ahead and knock, and the door will be open. I know for faith and prayer puts God to work for you. Faith in God each moment of the day. Prayer in your heart every step of the way. Go on and walk in his precepts. Whatever you do, for faith and prayer puts God to work for you. Open your heart and let Jesus in. He will remove your burden of sin. Did you know Jesus wants to be your sweetest and dearest friend? So open your heart now and let his word in. Oh, take his hand, take his nail-scarred hand, and Jesus will show you the way. Oh, he may not pass this way again. So open wide your heart now and let his word in. Oh, glory. I'm just a pilgrim down here. This old world, This old world is not my home. You're gonna get up and look for old brother Freddy some morning. Boy, and I'll be gone to my brand new home. And where am I going? I'm going to where the wicked shall cease their troubling. Oh yeah. The weary shall be at rest. Oh, well, all of God's saints through the ages, oh yes, are gonna sit at his feet and be blessed. That way you're going. It's a wicked world out there, but the wicked shall cease their troubling. Oh, the weary shall be at rest. Oh yeah. Well, all of God's saints through the ages are gonna sit at his feet and be blessed. Oh, if you should ever come to my house and you find that old brother Freddy, well, he's gone. Well, come on over. Come on over. Come on over the river. You'll find me. I'll be shouting all around God's white throne. You know where I'll be? I'll be where the wicked shall cease their troubling. Oh, yeah. Weary shall be at rest. Well, all of God's saints through the ages, oh, are gonna sit at his feet and be blessed. This past fall, winter, actually February, we was in Jacksonville in a meeting, and we had a great meeting in Jacksonville for old brother Davis that I hadn't seen for many years. And about the end of the meeting, I started getting weak, and I had been in great physical stress and straits since 1st of October of last year, and suffered for 5 months. Nearly a dozen times I died, had all I could do to stay in the body, at least 12 times. I hung on for the sake of, first of all, raising the kids, and second of all, raising the church. Hallelujah. And I was on my way to Alexandria because of the Times Conference when we left that last night meeting in Jacksonville, and knowing me, I always push myself. Well, before the night was over, I was in the Jacksonville Hospital. And there was nothing they could do for me. I was just in the hospital. After a while, the Lord raised me up, and I was able to walk out of the hospital, but I was still in a weakened condition, and I had irregularity with my heart. Now, there was nothing that was ever found wrong with my heart as far as blockages or veins or this, that, or the other, but the electrical impulses went all haywire and messed up the beating, and I wasn't pumping blood, and I didn't have strength, and I did walk out of the hospital, and all night long I rode in the minivan to go to Louisiana from Jacksonville. I was looking for people to pray for me. I was also looking to hear from the Lord. I love to go to convocations. All night long I played that tape. And it was the only thing that got me through the night. The wicked shall cease their troubling. The weary shall be at rest. All of God's saints through the ages
she'll sit at his feet and be blessed. And that left a mark on me, and that song meant a lot to me. And there's an anointing that goes with everything, especially when you've lived it, you've suffered it, you've gone through it, it's part of you. And that was part of me, and that's why you felt something when I was singing it. I felt something myself. There's another verse to it. Give me that chord again. Oh, glory to God. I don't mind a few lies that's been told on me. Yeah, I don't mind rebuke and scorn. Because every time they tell something that just ain't true about me, that's just another brick in my brand new home. Oh, the wicked shall cease their troubling. Oh, hey, the weary shall be at rest. Oh, all of God's saints through the ages, oh, I'm gonna sit at His feet and be blessed. I don't mind a few lies been told on me. I don't mind rebuke and scorn. 'Cause every time they tell something that just ain't true about me, you know what? That's another brick in my brand new home. Oh yeah, where the wicked shall cease their troubling. Oh, all the weary shall be at rest. Now all of God's saints through the ages, oh yes, I gotta sit at His feet and be blessed. They came and they were blessed. Their weary souls found rest. And He caused the blinded eyes to see. He made the lame to walk. And He made the dumb to talk. By the shores of the blue Galilee. There's where He did it. He's going to do it here tonight too. They came and they were blessed. And the weary souls found rest. And He caused the blinded eyes to see. Then He fed the multitude on heaven's angel food. Went by the shores of the blue Galilee. Reach out and touch the Lord as He goes by. You will find He's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. Oh, He's passing by this moment, every need to supply. Reach out and touch the Lord as He goes by. You can let Jesus fix it for you. He knows just what to do. Oh, whenever you pray,
Let him have his way. Oh, let Jesus fix it for you. If your child's in the devil's prison and you don't know what you're ever gonna do, If you need a great big lawyer, hey, if it's a lawyer, I know who to get. I recommend my Lord to you. Take the recommendation now. I recommend my Lord to you. Yes, I do. I recommend my Lord to you. If you're sick tonight and you need a great big doctor, I'll tell you who to get. I recommend my Lord to you. Oh, leave it there, leave it there. Take your burden to the Lord and leave it there. If you trust and never doubt, God will surely bring you out. Oh, take your burden to the Lord and leave it there. Are you enjoying these old choruses? I know there's probably very few of what I've sung already that you've ever heard in your life. But after 5 decades in Pentecost and got my teeth on a church pew, lived in tents most of my life, this brings me back memories. That's how it was back in 40s and 50s, back in the days of the Voice of Healing. The Voice of Healing was a healing fellowship that was begun by first William Branham, who was a great preacher of that time and a prophet. And though he was uneducated and he didn't have the knowledge to put together a fellowship, still Gordon Lindsay knew how to do that, and so he was the brains and the ghostwriter and the organizer of that particular fellowship, which was a lot of preachers that had left denominationalism, especially Pentecostal denominationalism, only because Pentecostal denominationalism in that particular era decided that they were not going to support the sign gift ministry or the supernatural operation of the gifts of the Spirit. They called it latter rain. They called it all manner of things. And of course, there was a lot of duds and a lot of crooks and a lot of people that were half-baked and off the wall. You're going to have that all the time. But a banker will not go out of business because you run across a counterfeit dollar bill. He throws it in the trash and keeps on banking. They had to have been copying something. They had to get the idea from somewhere. QC, although Brother Branham was only one particular voice in that fellowship, he seemed to be the one that instigated or started it all off. And I'm going to sing his favorite song for you, one chorus through. Only believe. Only believe, all things are possible if you only believe. This was his theme song. Only believe, only believe, all things are possible if you only believe. In my daddy's day, there was a great effort in Pentecostalism, which had just been poured out at the turn of the century, to keep the unity of the Spirit until everyone could come into the unity of the faith. Hello. And that continued on, and every faction seemed to be able to worship together. In the 40s, early 40s, when I was born, I noticed that in that decade there was a departure. A departure from the fellowship, and the mindset was, bless God, if you go to that church across town, you're going to hell. Hello. Fellowship's two fellows in the same ship. That puts us all in the same boat, paddling in the same direction. And fellowship was something that was being avoided, and we suffered for the lack of fellowship. And in the 50s, I noticed a departure from the supernatural, or backing or supporting the supernatural ministry, which is why you had in that decade this particular movement in our country called the Voice of Healing. Another fellow that was in that particular fellowship was a great tent evangelist by the name of Jack Coe. I don't know if you ever heard tell of that name, and I'm talking history here tonight for a little while to you Pentecostals. And remember, Pentecost is not a denomination, it's an experience. So experience the experience, because a man with an experience got more than a man of an argument. And his theme song was, see again. I can feel the hand of Satan as the tempter pressed me sore. He has been before the Father asking leave to tempt me more. But though God slay me, yet I'll trust him. Well, I shall then come forth as gold, and I know that he still liveth. Oh, for I feel him in my soul. There were many, many men in that particular fellowship, and they'd have a big tent up in a big city or even a small city, and one night you'd have Gail Jackson and folks would get the Holy Ghost. Another night you'd have Richard Vineyard and short legs would grow out. Blind eyes were open, because that was his specialty. I know a lot of you today would like to do everything and all things, but you'll find that you'll specialize. God specializes in things found impossible, and he will do what no other power can do. Hallelujah. He hath divided to the whole body severally as he will. And though there are those that have more than one gift, you should at least have one. For unto one is given the gift of, and to another is given the gift of. And on down the line it said, and don't limit the Holy One of Israel either. And you that's got five talents, you can get five more if you're a mind to go to work. You that's got 10, you could get 10 more. And the worst thing you could do is bury it in the ground. Wicked, slothful, lazy servant. Hallelujah. At least send it to the bank and get some interest. Now, I'm not here endorsing ministries and men tonight. I'm just taking you back. A lot of these men had their problems. A lot of these men had, some went down in glory, some went down in disglory. Hallelujah. But that's not that we are not supposed to remember them at their zenith and at their heyday, and we'll never learn anything from their lives until we see them in their best and in their habitat and how God used them at their zenith. That is here for our lesson. And all the things in the Bible is the same way from Genesis to Revelation. Every character that we read about has happened, the scripture said, for you're in the sample, that you should not also err, or that you should also be inspired. Amen. There was another evangelist toward the end of the Voice of Healing days. Well, he was, toward the end of those days. He was in his own ministry then, and that particular fellowship seemed to fall apart. His name was A.A. Allen. Some of you will remember that name because he's more recent. And his favorite song and his theme song was, better give me F. I am going to a city, oh, where the streets with gold are laid, oh, and there the tree of life is blooming, oh, yes. Oh, and the roses never fade. Oh, now here they bloom, but for a season. But I am going to a city, yes I am, and it's where the roses never fade. Or you might hear this, there's gonna be meeting tonight, meeting here tonight, meeting on the old campground. Gonna be meeting tonight, meeting tonight, whoa, meeting on the old campground. They'll be shouting tonight, shouting here tonight. I said they're shouting on the old campground. Gonna be preaching tonight, praying here tonight, preaching, praying, singing, shouting on the old campground. There's gonna be glory tonight, power tonight, Holy Ghost and moving on the old campground now. Glory tonight and healing here tonight. Power on the old campground. I'll sing it one time. Gonna be meeting tonight. On the old campground, oh, liberty tonight, power of God tonight, power on the old campground, oh, victory tonight. Where's the meeting on the old campground? There's a meeting here tonight, meeting down here tonight, gonna be meeting on the old campground. And by and by, when the morning comes, oh, when the saints of God have gathered home, we will tell the story, how we overcome, and we'll understand it better by and by. Oh, by and by, when the morning comes, when the saints of God have gathered home, the story, how we understand it better. On the top of Mount Zion sits a city, and the earth its glory it doth fill. I shall go and meet you in the morning, when I reach that city on the hill. Oh, the city called Mount Zion, though a pilgrim, yet I love it still. I'll never leave it through the ages. I'm gonna reach for the city on the hill. Now I got just what I wanted. I've got just what I wanted. I've got just what I wanted from the Lord. what I'm after. I'm getting just what I wanted, and I've got just what I wanted from the Lord. And when the battle's over, we shall wear a crown. We shall wear a crown. We shall wear a crown. I said, when this battle's over, we shall wear a crown in the new Jerusalem. Wear a crown. Wear a crown. Wear a bright and a shining crown. Oh, when the battle's over, we shall wear a crown in the new Jerusalem. Well, up above my head, there's music in the air. Up above my head, there's music in the air. Up above my head, there's music in the air. Oh, Lord, I surely do believe, believe there's a heaven somewhere. Up above my head, there's music in the air. Up above my head, there's music in the air. Up above my head, there's music in the air. Oh Lord, I surely do believe, believe there's a heaven somewhere. I surely do believe, believe, believe there's a heaven somewhere. Oh Lord. Up above my head, there's power in the air. Angels in the air. The Holy Ghost is in the air. There is a higher power. When burdens seem to overcome, there's a higher power. Who's faithful and refuses none, there's a higher power. Why ask men to help you through? There's a higher power. They're helpless pilgrims just like you. There's a higher power. Now these men have built these mighty guns, but there's a higher power. They built these automobiles that run, but there's a higher power. Now, brother and sister, mark this down. There's a higher power. They can't build you no heavenly crown, but there's a higher power. Go tell those people lost in sin, there's a higher power. They need not fear the works of men. There's a higher power. Believe on him and you'll rest on high, because there's a higher power. But unless you do, you'll surely, surely die. For there's a higher power. Amen. Amen. There's a higher power. Amen. Amen. Said there's a higher power. Let's sing and shout and walk and talk it. There's a higher power. Lay down your soul with Jesus' body. There's a higher power. And there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Now what can wash away my sin? Now what can make me whole again? Oh, oh, precious is the flow that makes me white as snow. At the cross where I first saw the light, parted from all of my sin and strife. There to my heart was the blood applied, where I shouted glory to his name. I shouted glory to his name. Don't you want to do it? And shout glory, glory, glory to his name. There to my heart was the blood applied. Oh, glory,
to his name.
At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burden of my heart rolled away. It was there, by faith, I received my sight. That's why I'm so happy all the day. Alas, and did my Savior bleed? And did my Sovereign die? Yes, he did. And would he devote that sacred head for such a word as I? And he did that too. He did it at the cross where I first saw the light. Well, I've enjoyed the singing here tonight. Sing on to the Lord a new song. Whatever you do, you got to do it out of your heart and do it in the Spirit. Anything shy of that is idolatry. You can't worship music. You got to take music and worship God. The only worship God can ever contact is spirit worship. And you know why? Because he is a spirit. And he cannot reach your worship by anything less than his own essence. So if you're just going through the motions of the flesh, no good. If you rose a little higher and you got to worshiping and singing soulishly, not good enough. God wants spirit worship. He wants his spirit entwined of your human spirit, and thus the worship. You have been quickened who was dead in trespasses and sin. But if the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you, he that raised up Jesus from the dead shall quicken your mortal body by his spirit that dwelleth in you. I don't know how to pray or sing or shout like I ought to, but the Holy Ghost prays and shouts and sings through me with great groaning sometimes, with great shouting sometimes. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah to God. Oh, glory. How are you coming? Are you getting fine-tuned yet? Focused and channeled and harnessed? You're getting on the spot with God. You don't mind being put on the spot if you get out on the spot with him. You got to dare to believe God, brother. You'll always run a risk. But if you're his child, he'll never let you down. And if you stay in your perimeter, you won't get in left field when the ball's in right. You won't major on a minor. You won't get two trains on the same track. Everything will be decent and in order. For God is no author of confusion. And he's no respecter of persons. The Lord is with thee as thou art with him. In times past he promised that he'd be with you forever. But later on, said the prophet, he's decided he'd just stay with those who stayed with him. Hallelujah. I'm feeling mighty fine. You may be seated. Tell me how deep. You feel when you left the wilderness. You left the wilderness. You left the wilderness. Tell me, how did you feel when you left the wilderness? Was you walking with my Lord? Sister back here in the blue, stand and tell us how you felt when you left the wilderness. What'd you feel like doing? Our sister felt free when she left the wilderness. So free when she left the wilderness. Free when she left the wilderness. Our sister felt free when she left the wilderness. Walking with her Lord. And what's your name, sister? Courtney. Courtney felt free when she left the wilderness. Amen. Our sister ain't back here in the green dress. Rise and tell us how you felt when you came out of the wilderness.
Glorious.
And what's your name?
Cora
Sinclair. Sister Sinclair felt glorious when she left the wilderness. She left the wilderness. She left the wilderness. Sister Sinclair felt glorious when she left the wilderness. She was walking with her Lord. Brother here in the short sleeves, rise and tell us how you felt.
Glorious.
Well, John, your name? Brother Steve felt joy when he left the wilderness. He left that old wilderness. He left that old wilderness. Brother Steve felt full of joy when he left the wilderness. He was walking with our Lord. Brother here in the red tie, stand and tell us how you felt.
I felt like I got a great big hug. Great big hug.
Brother Tony got a great big hug when he left the wilderness. He left that old wilderness. He left that old wilderness. Brother Tony got a great big hug. He left the wilderness. He was walking with my Lord. Brother in the white shirt back there, stand and tell us how you felt.
Rest. I could finally sleep through the night.
And your name? Brother Terry slept through the night when he left the wilderness. He left the wilderness. He left the wilderness. Brother Terry got plenty of rest when he left that old wilderness, walking with my Lord. Sister back here in the green, would you stand and tell us how you felt? And your name? Sister Margaret felt happiness when she came out of the wilderness. She left that wilderness. She left the wilderness. Sister Margaret felt happiness when she left the wilderness. And she's walking with my Lord. Well, glory to God. Thank the Lord. Our sister back here from Maryland right there. Rise and tell us how you felt.
Floating
in your name. Sister Janice felt like floating when she came out of the wilderness. Came out of her wilderness. Left that old wilderness. Sister Janice felt like floating when she left the wilderness. She's walking with her Lord. My. Glory. Sister right here, the brown hair and glasses right through there. Stand and tell us how you felt.
I got direction.
Direction in your name?
Cynthia.
Sister Cynthia got direction when she came out of the wilderness. She came out of the wilderness. She came out of that wilderness. Sister Cynthia got direction when she left the wilderness. Cause she's walking with her Lord. Ah, thank God. Do you know a little bit about the wilderness? How many do? How many remembers a little bit about Egypt? Remember that? That was before the wilderness. I mean, we can go way back here. Under Pharaoh's whiplash and bondage lay the children of Israel, who were God's people, but they was in Egypt, a type of the world. They were bound, fettered, chained, slaves, never had enough strength, never had enough sleep, never had enough rest, never had enough food, never had enough time, never had enough worship. And they never had enough straws to make bricks, and never enough bricks to make sepulchers for dead pharaohs. And we sure don't want that job, do we? In other words, they never had enough. And if you're wondering why it is that you've just never had enough, you might still be in Egypt. Though you may still be God's child. Hello. Well, I want to get enough, don't you? Thank God. Down in Egypt, they never had enough, and that was a significant of Egyptian bondage. But when they left that night by the blood of the doorpost, that's when they left Egypt. And they entered into the wilderness by going through the Red Sea, the water. So far, we've got blood and water. And the next thing you know, they were led by the cloud and by the fire, spirit. These three agree in the earth. And they cannot be separated. Blood, water, and skin one. I can take the plasma, the purple powder out of my fluid in my carcass, and I'll die. That's the blood. It's soluble and red because of the water. I can extract the water, and I'll still die. I can leave the plasma in the water and take out my spirit, and I'll still die. It takes blood, water, and spirit for me to live. The life of the flesh is in the blood. Life is spirit. Spirit is life. Remember that. And if you think your life is in your carcass or your body, think again. Drain the blood out of your body and your spirit will have to leave. with the blood. Thank God. And now there's in the wilderness and they had just enough. Hello? The manna fell, none left over, none too little, none too much. The water spurted from the rock. There was never too much, never too little. When the last cow slurped up his last bucket of water, the rock dried up, though it chased them for 40 years to every town in the wilderness or every place they journeyed in the wilderness. And they never had anything left over. And there are people today that are just breaking even and just barely budgeting, and they just making it, and they have nothing left over, but they've got enough. The bills are all paid, and there's nothing left for God. Hello. They budgeted first, and God was the tail once more. That's because they're still in the wilderness. And those that's in the wilderness just have exactly enough. But I got a feeling this seminar is going to do something about making us come on over the river. Over there where he'll dry it up if you just stick your foot in it. He'll work a miracle for you. And cross over to the other side. And there in Cana, the grapes of Escu grow and the milk and honey flow. In fact, everything there is flowing, 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 flowing. There's more than enough if you can only find Cana. The land of your Christian experience, your pilgrimage, the giants are big and the cities are walled and times are tough. But if you take it by faith, you conquest the Canaan's land. You will not be defeated over there. You will get in the flow where it flows. Honey flows, milk flows, wine flows, everything about the whole country flowed. And all you need to do tonight is get in the flow. Now, some of you are already in the flow. Some of you are still dragging your feet. I'm just waiting on you. I'm in no hurry. I can't bring you a revival, and I can't drag it out of a suitcase. It's you that's got to get under the spout where the glory comes out. You got to get on the spot with God. You got to get where things are flowing. Get in the flow. Hello. Until you get in the flow, you'll never have more than enough. Now, I need you to have more than enough, because if you don't have enough for yourself, how are you going to help me? If you've got just exactly enough, you're still no good to me, you wilderness wanderer, you. Hallelujah. I need you where you got more than enough, and it's just busting out the seams, and he's filled your cup and saucer too, where you just give it away and it comes back onto you so fast, good measure, pressed down, shaking it, gathered, running over. Will he give it to your bosom? I need a blessing. I get drained myself. Everybody dragging on my coattail. Give me a blessing. Give me, pray for me, Brother Freddy. Pray for me. Hey, let me get you in Cana and in the flow where you got more than enough. And you'll bless me in spite of myself. You'll bless me in spite of yourself. You'll bump into me and heal me. Your shadow will pass by and I'll jump off my stretcher. Because you got more than enough. You got more than you'll ever use, and you can scatter it and share it and pass it abroad. Hallelujah to God. Glory to God. So who wants to have more than enough? God is here to dish it out to us and pour it upon us. That's very, very true. Glory be to God. I love you, Jesus. We're going on a little tour right about now, and we're going to hear from some of the ministry that's attending the seminar so we can get used to you and you can get acquainted with us and each other. And this is very important. We oftentimes do this on the first night of the seminar. And I'm looking forward to it. Now, we may not reach all of you tonight, but we got tomorrow night, and we got the next night. And we'll get all of you. Everyone will speak, and everyone will be recognized, and everyone will be heard from, and we'll know who you are before this is through. And I know you're not ashamed of your ministry. You're here to enhance it and to expand it. Oh, thank God. Now, remember, Israel wanted a king. This was one of Samuel's greatest heartaches. They wanted a man to rule over them. You know what God said? It's a sin. God said, that is a terrible error. Because when you get a man ruling over you, you don't have me ruling over you no more. Now, we know some folks are so scatterbrained, they need to be organized. Hello. But if you can't keep yourself straight, and you won't let God keep you straight, you'll probably have to find some man to keep you straight. That's why we have denominations and organizations and groups and groups. And after a while, everybody thinks that if you're not a card carrier in our group, you're not part of the body and you're not part of the folks that's leaving. That's far from the truth, my friend. Other sheep I have that are not of this fold, Jesus said. I got people everywhere. And one of these days when that man that you elected and chose to rule over you and to keep you straight decides he don't want you no more and takes your card, you're going to be very glad to come and see us and be a friend and to be in fellowship in the spirit. It's surprising what you do when you don't have a leg to stand on. Surprising what happens when the foundation's jerked out from underneath you. Say amen. And when the people cried for a king, the Lord said the only reason they want a king is because they don't want me ruling over them no more. Now, if I had a choice, I'd rather live in the perfect will than the permissive will. If I had a choice, I'd rather God keep me straight than to have the presbyters looking through my window. Say hallelujah. Of course, if I can't stay straight, then I better go get all the kings I can elect over me. And thus, though the men of Israel and Saul rejoiced on his coronation day, the next verse Samuel said, you're still in error. Rejoice all you want to, but you have done wickedly before God in asking for a king. Say hallelujah. Oh, let God be true and every man a liar. If God be for us, who can be against us? Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, let God be true, every man a liar. I want him, don't you? Hallelujah. Let's be keen and open to him and be able to hear from him tonight. Glory to God. If you're happy, say, thank God, I'm happy. Now, listen, all you preachers, teachers, and witnesses, all you apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, and teachers, don't preach. We just want to hear a word from you tonight, okay? Because we got a lot of folks here that we want to, the Lord to give us a word from. Say thank God. Are you happy? I believe this brother's with us from the state of Louisiana. I want him to come and stand and greet us, tell us who he is, and give us a short word.
I'm Bud Martin from Mendon, Louisiana. And this is a best man I ever known, really. He's as far as ministry, really. But we drove all the way up here to his ministry because we think so much of him, and we're glad to be here with you people. And may God bless every one of you.
And what's your name again, brother?
Bud Martin.
Brother Bud Martin from Mendon, Louisiana. Look, give him a good hand tonight. Tell us who you are, brother, and give us a short word.
My name's Jay Bissett. I came from Excelsior Springs, and I moved here. Yes, I want to look for a tent. We're going to have one this spring, my wife and I. But the Lord's done great things with us.
Amen. Here's a young man that's going to be a tent evangelist. Isn't that wonderful? I can certainly talk about tents, having been in them all my life. And your name again is?
Jay Bissett
from Excelsior Springs, Missouri. Well, he's in Rocky Mount now. He came a long way. Hallelujah. Praise God. Brother Hathaway is with us tonight. God bless him and God love him. He's from Maryland. The town is Salisbury, Maryland, where he pastors the Pentecostal church there. Come out here and greet us, brother. Ora Hathaway. I want to hug his neck anyway. Praise God.
Been my pleasure since the first time coming here to try to find as many people that's available to come and experience a little bit of something extra that God has made available through the ministry of our brother. Praise God.
God bless Brother Hathaway. And who's this with you? Amen. Another brother from Salisbury? From Delaware.
Yes, my name is Brother Wayne. I'm glad to be here tonight. I expect great things from God. Thank you.
You say Brother Wayne?
Brother Wayne from Delaware. Amen. Well, glory to God. And if you're happy, say, thank God I'm happy. Amen. Let's, brother, rise and greet us.
I'm Harold Howes from Central Florida. And I'm very glad to be here tonight. God saved me back in 1971 through the ministry of Brother Quentin Edwards. See him sitting here tonight. God bless you, Brother Edwards. And since then, he's been leading me and leading me and leading me. And he led me into a teaching ministry, and it just went right on into preaching ministry. And I'm waiting for more direction from God here tonight. Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. God bless him, and that's the truth. Your name again is what?
Harold Howes.
Brother Harold Howes. What did Samuel tell Saul? He said, now today you're going to eat with me. But tomorrow I'm going to let you go, but not before I tell you all that's in your heart. Oh, that Samuel was a prophet, man. And before you get set free tomorrow, well, you're going to eat tonight, but by the time you get set free tomorrow, maybe the Lord will tell you all that's in your heart. Hallelujah. Our good brother from Louisiana again, close to Mississippi. Brother McManus, come up here, Brother McManus. Good to see you. We've been at his church.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. It's good to be here in Rocky Mount, Virginia. Yes, I was what most people call a pastor, and I was a pester. I reckon you would call it that. That's what I say, but I'm not pastoring or pestering anymore. I've been evangelizing for the last 12 months, and some people call that evangelist. Well, you heard of foreign missionaries and home missionaries. Well, I'm a homeless missionary. So I found that out. But I tell you what is good. We have seen lots of people receive the baptism of the Holy Ghost. We have seen more miracles this year than we've ever seen. We've seen the blinded eyes open, the deaf ears unstopped, the lame to walk, devils being cast out. That's all the report I can give you, that God is moving in these last days. God bless you.
God bless you, Brother McManus. You know, David was living in a cave when there came to him the discontent, the distressed, and the folks that was in debt. That was 3D, three dimensions. And he was the fourth dimension. His name started with a D2. He taught them how to be an army and how to evangelize. Yes, he did. Praise God. Looks like a brother here from Florida.
My name's Paul Flamont. I'm from Gainesville, Florida, and just hungry for God, and I know I'm in the right place and looking forward to it.
These are all your buddies here. God bless them.
I'd like to thank God tonight for the Holy Ghost that he's given me many years ago. At 20 years old, there was a devil that was in me. He lived in me. God led me even then by his Spirit, told me what to do. And what God tells you, it does work. I've applied it, and it does work. And I'm here tonight to serve him and to the greatest capacity that he can use me in.
Amen. And your name, brother, again? Well,
J.C. Pop.
J.C.
Pop.
Pop. Well, he's going to pop the devil this week, I'll tell you. Amen. Here's another good brother. We want him to rise and greet us.
Stephen Martin's from Gainesville, Florida. Just glad to be here, and I'm here expecting great things. And if you just allow God, we can't do nothing without him, the Bible says. And if we just work on our relationship with him and let him lead us, then we can do great things for him. But if we try to do it in the flesh and do it by ourselves, it's not going to work. So we just stop thinking and let God do the work.
God bless our brother. Well, I feel better now. Glory to God. This brother will rise and greet us tonight.
I'm Coy Barker from Kingsport, Tennessee. And I want to give a testimony on the behalf of my daughter this year. Last year she came up, and the doctors had already told her that she was going to have trouble giving birth and that her baby was turned. And Brother Freddy prayed for her last year. Told her exactly what the doctors had told her, and everything was fine. The baby was born just right. Praise the Lord.
Wonderful. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Thank my God. This brother here, rise and greet us. Yes, from Pennsylvania. Brother Steve Coran, I know him well, yes.
That's okay. Amen. Steve Coran from Jersey Shore, Pennsylvania. And my wife and I started a church about almost 3 years ago, and ordained by Pastor Crandall and Brother Wayne and Margaret Holcomb from the Door Fellowship. And able to come down with my mom and dad sitting up front there, and we're just glad we're able to come and get all we can and get all we get. And amen. And appreciate Brother Freddy for this opportunity to learn more about the gifts of the Spirit and the things of God.
God bless you, Brother Steve. Now, Sunday morning, you were greatly blessed and treated here at the sanctuary with the ministry of Brother Quentin Edwards from Winter Haven, Florida, whom I've known for many, many years. I was very pleasantly surprised when he chose and desired to come and be in this seminar. Amen. And that's because he wants to get even deeper yet in that ministry that God has put upon him so many years ago. He's going to be a great blessing to you tonight as he stands and greets us.
Thank you, Brother Freddy. God has sent me into 51 nations to preach. I preached my 70th crusade in India last year. This year, I preached to 5,000 people on the Sea of Galilee in Israel, right near the mouth of the Jordan. This weekend, I've had my life touched. I came in here, and of course, I always desire to be a blessing wherever I go. And I told you for 3 or 4 years, I want to get up there and be in that seminar. And so this year, I just felt so definitely that I had to do it, because I'm not satisfied. I see God working in my life in a powerful way, but every time I've watched Brother Freddy in action, just makes me hungry for more, more, more. So this weekend, I've been so blessed being here in this place with Pastor Phil and Brother Joe Crandall, who is the brother of one of my dear friends. And now he's my dear friend. My, I've just been so blessed. And I told them, you know, I'm in and out of different kinds of Christians, and I move in and out of different camps, travel all over, preach everywhere, love God's people. I'm a member of the body, love the body of Christ. But I feel like I'm more comfortable in this tribe than I've been in a long time, this crowd where I've been this week. And I'll say this, tonight I humble myself before God. And Brother Freddy has set up his tent many times when I was a pastor on the property where we were having meetings, where we were preaching in Winter Haven. And God helped us to build a great building, and I walked away from it to go into world evangelism. And I'm convinced that the world will never see the real Jesus stand up until the gifts of the Spirit are in operation. And this week, I've analyzed my own life, and God uses me mightily, especially overseas, in the gifts of faith, the gift of working of miracles, the gift of healing. But I want more. So tonight I come with my heart open. I'm not bringing my cup. I'm bringing my whole heart. I want God to touch me afresh and anew. And I'm so grateful that God put you in my life so many years ago. I've watched this man operate in the Spirit. And I've said, God, I can't do it like that, but I sure want to do it the way you want me to do it, as much like that as I can. Because when the Holy Spirit's moving in Brother Freddy, it's incredible how precious and how real it is. So tonight I join with you, and I want more of God, more than ever before. Thank you, brother.
God bless you, Brother Edwards. I just want to save Brother Crandall here to last because he is the apostle of this work, and besides that, he is my father-in-law too. So he'll wait till I get down through the host here. I'm moving through the host right now. Brother on the end, come and greet us and tell us who you are and where you're from. Bless us.
I'm Richard Reed from Bedford, Pennsylvania. And me and my wife come down here to several conventions. And we just felt the Lord leading us to come to Bible school. And we have a dairy farm. And we put the farm for sale. And we said, God, just you just use us. You just whatever you want. And me and my wife's here, and we're just hungering and thirsting for God and His righteousness, and just praise God.
The journey of 1,000 miles begins at one step. Never despise the day of small things or the hour of humble beginnings. Again, your name is Richard Reed. Amen. This brother looks like he's bursting out at the seams here.
Brother Isaac Cox from High Point, North Carolina. And God does heal today. I have a personal experience with God. I was diagnosed with clinical depression, tried Zoloft, Prozac, all that. But when I come to God and He filled me with the Holy Ghost, God healed me of that. So He's here to heal us, and He still can. He's the same God on the day of Pentecost, and He's here to do it. He said, I am. I am means He was there, back there. He's here tonight, and He will always be.
Amen. Well, thank God. Amen to the Lord. Brother, rise and greet us.
My name is Richard Alexander, and I'm from White, New Brunswick, Canada. And I just come down for 2 or 3 days here to be with my tutor. Freddy doesn't know me too well, but I know him very well. I spent a lot of months in Canadian winters sitting at home by the fire listening to his tapes. And I thank God for Freddy's balance. I've been under the many men that are got big churches, and they just kind of shy away from the gifts of the Spirit, and I don't really feel that that is what our world needs. We need to be balanced, and you cannot be balanced without the gifts. And I've been interested in this. I've been into it a little bit. I'm not too far advanced, but I just come down here to be with you, all you folks here.
And your name again, brother, is?
Richard Alexander.
Richard Alexander, rise and greatest brother.
My name is Steve Singletary. I'm from Rite Oak, Virginia. I've been blessed by your ministry many years, and I can't even begin to describe the things that's gone through my life because of your ministry. You really blessed us. Really heavy.
That does sound heavy, doesn't it? This brother, Stan Greatest.
Well, praise the Lord, everybody. I'm Leonard Stafford, and I'm from Bedford, Virginia. And it's a privilege to be here tonight. And I love the Lord, and I'm not ashamed of what He's done for me. And I'm just thankful for setting me free from some of the religious bondage that I was in. And just thankful for everything that He's done, and looking forward to seeing the demonstration and power of the Holy Ghost tonight. God bless you.
God bless you, brother. Well, I'm happy now. Amen. Come down here, Brother Taylor. My goodness. Come down here and hug my neck. I'm going to hug yours.
Oh, yes. Greet us.
Amen. It's good to be back in Rocky Mount, Brother Clark. This is the fourth year of the gifts of the Spirit that I've been opportune to be here with you and be with the great people that are gathered here tonight. Amen. And it's there's a wonderful transference and an impartation that's just all around us tonight. God is so anxious, and there's such a contagious atmosphere. I sensed it just as I walked in the building, having just shortly gotten off the road, and I'm hungry, and I'm thirsty to receive what God has for all of us these few days. Amen. It's good to be among friends. And it's just good to be in the presence of the Lord tonight. Amen, Brother Clark.
God bless Brother Greg Taylor from Big Spring, Texas. had a great tragedy in his life here the last few months ago, but it looks to me like he's bubbling over with joy tonight. That's a miracle of God. It's a miracle of God. And our other brother, I know him. Brother Hodges, come here, Brother Hodges, and greet the folks here in Rocky Mount.
Brother Clark, it's good to be with you tonight. I came up with Brother Taylor, and he's been telling me about the seminar here for the last few years, and we've been wanting to come, and it's good to be in Virginia. It's beautiful here, but it's the presence of the Lord is so much more beautiful, and I'm looking forward to receiving from the Lord in this meeting. Praise God.
God bless Brother Hodges. Where are you from, Brother Hodges? In Big Spring, Texas. Now, things are building and tides rising and things are materializing and gelling, and Rome wasn't built in a day. And the slow and orderly growth of the kingdom is first the blade, then the ear, then the full corn in the ear. Hello. Amen. And judge nothing before the time till the Lord come and every hidden work of darkness be brought into light. And the worst thing you can do is just analyze in your own human reason of what is happening here tonight and where this thing is going, because you have no idea where it's going yet. Hallelujah. But we're searching. Isn't that wonderful? Isn't that exciting? Someone said, that's dangerous. Hey, it don't feel dangerous to me. It feels like a thrill to me. I just love to explore the will of God, don't you? Hallelujah. Brother Mays is here from the Cumberland Gap. Would you come, Brother Mays, and greet us tonight?
Thank you, Brother Clark. It's a privilege to be here in the house of the Lord. I'm thankful for the mercy of the Lord. I'm truly an example of the mercy of God, of the deliverance he's brought in my life. But I'm thankful for his keeping his hand upon me. Praise the Lord. I'm sure everybody can testify to that. But I'm here to get my deaf ears unstopped. I'm here to get my blinded eyes opened. I'm here to get my senses opened. I'm hungry for more of God. Because I know if I can get my blinded eyes open and my deaf ears unstopped and my dull senses sensitized, I can do the work God's called me to do. I can reach those hungry souls that he wants me to reach. Because I know they're there. I know there are hungry souls out there waiting for somebody to bring them the gifts of the Spirit, the power of God, the anointing of God. This world needs the power and demonstration of the Spirit. And somebody to stand up in this hour and say, I'm not giving in. I'm going to stand and I'm going to see the move of God. And it can happen if we'll just do it.
God bless you, Brother Mays. From the Cumberland Gap, Virginia, Tennessee, and Kentucky. All in the same spot, right? Where they all join. Amen. Our brother here, rise and greet us tonight.
Praise the Lord. I'm Brother Rick Holt from Knoxville, Tennessee, and I too am here searching and hungering for more of the power of Jesus Christ.
Brother Rick Holt, God bless you, and we're glad to have you.
Brother Hanks, you might not remember, we've met a couple of times. Good to be here. Good to be here with you folks. We're entering a special time. You know that we're coming up on the birth anniversary of Jesus. We're about to enter the third millennium since his birth. We know that the third day was a special time when the world got to see Jesus in a special way. And I believe, Brother Clark, that it's time for the world to see Jesus now at this hour in that special way. And so it's time for a resurrection. And so I'm here with the rest of y'all, a Bible teacher, evangelist, just hungry for the great things of God.
Thank God. Bless you, Brother Hanks. Amen. My brother on the very front row.
Surprise. I'm Harry McNutt. I'm from O'Fallon, Illinois. I met Brother Clark twice. This is third. I believe that the Lord has used me in various areas, but there's come a fear. not within myself, but that which has been placed as authority over me. I come here with a hunger and a desire to do the will of God. I want to see more things happen. I'm hungry. How could I put it? I want to be like the leopards were outside of the camp. If we perish here, we perish. But if we go into the city and if we perish there, we perish. But the Lord performed a miracle and fed not only them, but many people. I'm here. I want to be fed. I want to know what the will of God is for me.
God bless you, brother. You see, name was Brother McNutt?
Yes, sir.
From O'Fallon, Illinois. Amen. Our brother here, rise and greet.
My name is Brother Dave Evans. I'm from Newark, Ohio. We have a 74-year-old preacher lady that started a little church there about 3 years ago. Now we're carrying about 80. I preach out of the church also. She says something that's really good, that blessed is the preacher that can testify and not preach. Well, I don't know if too many preachers can do that. But I just thank God for the Holy Ghost and for fire and for a hunger and a knowledge that there's a world that needs Jesus out there.
Amen. And again, your name is?
Dave Evans.
Dave Evans. God bless Brother Evans. Brother Coran, I know him. He's from Williamsport, Pennsylvania.
Praise Lord Freddy. What a joy to be here. I received your newsletter and find out that you had this seminar. That's the first time I'm here. I'm overwhelmed already. I'm here to expect. I want all of Jesus. That's why I'm here. I met Freddy down in Florida when he met his wife. I was there to their wedding, and there were just two of them. And every time I see him, it's added to the kingdom. Now I'm looking forward for the twin girls to see tonight. Oh, praise the Lord. My wife and I are overwhelmed. We're so glad to be here tonight, Freddy. God bless you for your ministry. I love you.
Hang on, Brother Crane. Hang on. Yeah, there's 13 of us now. Start off with two. Brother Rise, greetings.
Praise the Lord. My name is Mason Beal. This is probably my third or fourth visit here to Rocky Mount. I'm just here to be filled and just growing and want to flow in the Spirit. This is a brand new experience for me. But just praise y'all and thank you for the opportunity to be here with you.
Amen. Brother Mason. God bless you, Brother Mason.
Amen. Praise the Lord. My name is Brother Jimmy Gilbert. I pastor Open Arms Way of Holiness Church in Bassett, Virginia. I come for one thing, and that's a faith walk with Jesus Christ. Wherever my steps is, I want them to be for the Lord. Glory to God. I've come to know this church through a good brother that I used to party with in the world. Now we party together in Jesus Christ. Amen. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I've got a desire. I've got a desire, and God knows my heart. I want to see the blinded eye open. We'll see the blinded eye open and the deaf ear to come to him. Glory to God, and see the lame to walk. Hallelujah. I want to see the miracles of God. In the church there where I'm at, it's free. It's where the liberty of the Spirit is. Glory to God, I can do what the Lord leads me to do. Ain't no man over me. Jesus Christ is the Lord and the Lord of the church. Glory to God. Ain't but one church, and I'm in it. Praise God. God bless y'all, and I'm looking for a blessing in the Lord.
Amen. Amen. And tell us your name once more. Brother Jimmy Gilbert, Bassett, Virginia. Did you enjoy that? That little spark plug right there, I'll tell you. We're moving on here. I want Brother Crandall, the founder of the work, to come down and greet you and put his blessing on what's happening. So, Brother Joseph Crandall, make him welcome.
Amen. Well, I'm excited tonight over the presence of the Lord that I feel in this place. We have all experienced just God hovering hovering over this entire place tonight. I believe expectation is in order tonight. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. 60 years ago, a great prophecy, great prophet, prophesied Smith Wigglesworth to Lester Summerall. And he said, Lester, he was a young man,